ndinotora mapiritsi eshuga pandotora mapiritsi eshuga inisitere kuti ndipowe nemedical aid ndakasvika ndakudaidzwa 105.
This man's case is just but one of many medical aid subscribers who are having to bear the burden of paying in cash or being charged a huge shortfall for medical services rendered despite having up-to-date medical aid policies. Medical funders claim the shortfalls are being caused by the pricing structure whereby doctors are using the parallel exchange rate, yet medical aid members are contributing to medical aid societies in RTGS dollars.
Unfortunately, the AFOS rates cannot be changed chasing the parallel rate because medical aid contributions are based on salaries, and salaries have not been changing. If at all, when they change, they do not change according to the parallel exchange rate. So that has created a mismatch whereby if a patient goes to seek healthcare services, the doctor will simply look, or that healthcare service provider will look at the exchange rate for that day. The difference is what the patient is asked to pay. So the system is still working. If we could stick to one system of doing things, we are supposed to be using the local currency, but the moment there is referencing to the US dollar, it creates that distortion.
The answer to the ongoing impasse lies in the speedy finalization and implementation of the medical aid bill, according to medical providers who feel shortchanged by medical aid societies.
The relationship between service providers and medical aid societies or medical insurance players has been marked by animosity over the past few or quite a number of years now. And what we feel is that there is no respect of boundaries and clear, ways in which things are supposed to be managed. And we have called for and continue to call for the speedy finalization and implementation of the Medical Aid Societies Bill, which has been on the cards since 2004.
The Medical Aid Societies Bill will, among other things, provide a national health safety net to all citizens, address issues of conflict of interest involving the owning and running of hospitals by medical insurers, as well as timeframes for remittances of claims. Jeanette Munyaka, ZBC News, Harare.